to the E to the L to the U to the X to the E to the top. Hey there guys, it's Qwerty Afro here, bringing you another video, and today's a bit of a special one, another new release, and it is World of Subways Volume 4. World Subways 4, now they've changed the name pretty much, and we're back in New York again. If you guys didn't know, the first game was pretty much set in New York as well, so it's a bit weird that they went back to it, but it looks good, and definitely was really excited to play it. I've been looking forward to this game for quite some time, so got it, played it, and I'm definitely thoroughly enjoying it. Bringing you a video of it, start off a little let's play, hopefully bring you a good amount of videos, because there's quite a lot of content actually with this game, and in all fairness, if you think about it, with all the kind of shift duties and stuff like that. But anyway, shoutouts for this video go to Kevin Stewart and Jay Lowe. That's Kevin Stewart and Jay Lowe. Their links and stuff will be down below. Now, to kind of just quickly, I'm going to quickly go through the menus just to show you where it is. You have this kind of carbon background or whatever, which is interesting. Then, if you go into settings, you have game, you have, you know, your normal kind of typical settings with like AI passengers, AI cars. So, if you have a lower system spec, lower it, so it'll be a little less taxing on your system. Unit system, I just left it in American because we are in America, so there's an excuse there. Graphics. I've definitely tweaked around, tried to get the best kind of graphics I can. I definitely recommend turning some stuff off to make it run smoother. Like, I've turned off NTA listening. It's definitely something that doesn't really run well with my computer. But overall, that's all how I've left my settings, and it's so far so good. And then you have like audio and stuff like that. Nothing really too different there. And then controls, general, nothing too important there with the mouse. And then player, you can now have A and D, which is really cool. In World of Subways Volume 3, you didn't have A and D, you just had to go WS and turn around with the mouse and then go in that direction or whatever, so it's really cool. You have like the route terminal and stuff like that. You have flashlight, so you can go like exploring in the tunnels and use a flashlight like you did in World of Subways Volume 2, and I think you did in Volume 3, I'm not too sure. And then you have the vehicle one, and this is the one that I would suggest reading up a lot on and learning. And yeah, it's definitely very different to the previous games, and it's definitely going to take some time getting used to, like it did for me. But other than that, that's pretty much the menu. We're going to get into the game now. I'm going to start off a new game. I did record this previously, this beginning bit while I'm talking right now, but it got cut out somewhere in the editing process, annoyingly. I'm just going to go into the video that I recorded, and it's just basically starting off with me just loading into the new game, showing you what happens when you load straight away fresh into a new game. Hope you guys enjoy it.
I only did it for the video,
like a test, but this will just show you what I opened up the game to, and you'll see what actually... It's kind of funny, actually. I'm not going to lie. It's actually kind of funny. But we'll go into it, and we'll see what you guys think of it. When I opened it up and when I saw this, I was just like, whoa, okay, what is going on here? Like, what kind of game is this? And it kind of just walks you through the kind of depot. This is actually the depot and stuff here. I thought this was really funny, just like looking at the secretary go by, like, really? That was a bit funny. But if we can... I don't think we can skip, but I don't think there's much of this to it. It's only a few minutes, it's great though. It's a bit different. It's a bit of fun, and that's what I like that they've done this time with the World of Subways next installment of this game. I think they've done something a bit unique and special here. It's funny, I have to say. It is funny. So we're gonna go into now the director's office and say hello to the director.
Hey, you must be the new guy. Take a seat. Welcome to the New York Transport Association.
Yeah.
I'm Jason McKenzie, and I'm running the shop.
Cool.
Okay, what's your name?
See, now just type in your name. You can't use cap lock, so you have to use shift. So I'm just going to type in... Oh, God, I can't spell. QWERTY Afro. Afrop.
That should do it for... Well,
I'm going to skip some of this because and I'm going to skip the tutorial
Mrs.
as well.
Taylor, go and tell Mr. Flint to come around. That's our shift leader. He'll sort you out.
Yeah. Cool. We'll get to him as well. I'm just going to skip some.
Flint,
this is your. This is our shift leader.
Here's the new guy. Go show him around. Okay, will do.
And then we get taken by him. get shown around, which is just, it's just hilarious. I thought this beginning bit was hilarious, and I like the whole integration of having this depot, having these NPCs to interact with and talk with, like you're in an actual company. By the way, I'm Steven. Yeah, cool. Some of this isn't like perfect, right, like
just
obviously.
Next to the boss's office, you'll find our pearl, Lindsay.
Like, I don't think this is their best trait of, like,
just
you know, modeling
you'll find the
character. The modeling's actually
that's
not too bad,
now.
But the whole
you
kind of camera work is a bit dodgy.
Your shift starts.
And he just takes us around, gets to show us these camera angles are just a bit shoddy.
If you need me, I'll be next to the boss's office.
Cool. We can skip all
and
of
if
this.
If you had too much coffee and need,
and then there's then
the
there's
canteen.
The toilets. You can actually go into the toilets, which is kind of funny. And now we move around ASWD, which is pretty cool. All good, really. Now we get to go into the canteen, and we have to, I'm gonna go forward, but he's behind me.
Ooh. Here's our canteen where you can get everything you need. Now we'll get to the heart of.
Cool. I want to go and drive the trains, please. Follow Steve to the workshop. So there's loads of NPCs around here. Some of them most of these are actually drivers. You can interact with all of them, and some of them will have missions. That's why that's the little mission thing at the top right, which has there's like 8 missions within the depot that you can do, and then you have the normal kind of thing where you kind of sign up to a shift to do, and then it's really good actually. Come on, let's go, let's go. This is the depot.
Here's our maintenance shop. That's where the trains get checked and repaired.
I know, yes. And I want to start a schedule. I hope it gives me a good one. Actually, do I get to pick my schedule? I want to start my schedule. Okay, I get plopped up into, I put regular because that's what I'm doing. There's this thing actually where you can do an AI conductor, which is actually pretty cool. So well it's just normal really. It will automatically open the doors for you. It will just automatically open the doors for you and automatically close the doors, and you just do the driving. You can turn it off, and then you kind of, I don't know if there's a pure conductor mode because I haven't found that out yet, but right now if you turn off the conductor AI, you basically then have to, when you stop, you have to go into the conductor camera and then you have to open the doors there and close the door there and come back to the driver. I don't know if you can, I haven't tried it. I think you can, if you get out of your train and then go onto an AI train, you can actually hop onto an AI train like you did in World of Subways Volume 3, and then I think from there you can maybe go into the conductor thing and conduct for another driver, possibly. I don't know, I'm not too sure, but we're gonna have the conductor AI on. So we're in our cab, as you can see. It's I think it's very detailed. My overall kind of opinion of this game, and actually before we, I'm going to actually go back to the depot because I want to put it into a nice sunny kind of setting. I don't want it to be foggy. We'll do it in another video. There's a lot of weather stuff that you can do. So back in the depot here, we're going to go into the staff. So this is where you would go and get your shifts. You go and talk to this guy, Steven.
Good to see you. I haven't penciled you in for the new duty plan. Which shift is the most interesting for you?
Right, so this is now the new shift kind of screen with like picking up shifts and stuff like that, which I think is brilliant. It's absolutely well done. Back to like how World of Subways Volume 2 and even the first one, which have both had shift duties, and I don't know why it was taken out of World of Subways Volume 3. It's all now within here, and it's broken down really well. As you know, you're going to have a local service and you're going to have an express service. And it's either one way. You don't have express services going either way because you know there's only just a single track. There isn't a bi-directional track where an express service can go. So sometimes I think during the year the express service goes one way, and then other times it goes the other way. So it's a bit different. So, and also you have like the weather here which you can change. I'm going to do it to sunny now because I really just want like really nice weather. Then you have like the tutorial, which I've already done. I would suggest anyone that is not new to the, well, to be honest, even people that have played the previous games, I would do the tutorial because there's quite a lot of stuff that's been changed around and moved around with the controls. You also have quick start, which gets you just going quickly. I like to just start a shift and I'll show you guys how it'll be going. So we're going to pick, we're going to say pick March, pick maybe a Friday. And you can see here that there's you need to select first a shift, and then you have shifts that are without express, which is just local, and then you have ones that have express. So we're going to pick somewhere maybe in the afternoon, like at, something like that. I think that's all right. So when you press one, so like say this one, now you have to select the schedule. So right now we could start from the depot, and which we're going to do in this video. We're going to start from St. Queen's station, which is just outside the depot, where we start from the depot, and then we'll go to Manhattan, Times Square, Manhattan. And then when we get there, we which we'll probably do in the next video, where I'll do a video of the Times Square, Manhattan to Flushing Meadows Express. And that is basically an express service that will run from that that part of the New York to the other side, where to Flushing Main Street, Main Cent Street. I can't say New York station names properly, they're just too long with the names and the street names or whatever, but Flushing Main Street, Main Street, St. Queens or whatever. So in a sense, we're going from the depot, we're going to Times Square, Manhattan, and then from there, we're going to do an express service to Flushing, Main. And that's how it works with the express. You don't have expresses in both directions, as I've said. So we're going to start from the depot. You don't have to start from the depot. You can start from other stations and you can pick a spawning station. So right now we're going to start our shift from here, from the depot. And then if you actually follow the whole shift to the very end, and this is where the shifts like start, you can do a shift from 2:31 p.m. to 10:52 p.m. and you can do the whole thing where you do like one way express, then local the other way, express, local, express, local, until the very end at wherever it ends at 10:20 p.m. where you actually come back and drive back to the depot. So you can do a full shift, a proper full shift from depot, out you go, do your runnings, and then come back to the depot. So that is really, really cool. I like that. So for now in this video, we're gonna, I know I've been talking a lot, I want to show you guys what this whole game is about. That's why I've been talking a lot. So now let's finally get into the train. So we're gonna select from Queens, St. Queen Street, which is just outside the depot. Select our starting station. You don't have to start from the depot, you can start from anywhere you want really, but I'm gonna start from the depot. So we're gonna pick that, and then I'm gonna start shift.
Good, that's your shift then. Drive carefully, but stick to the schedule.
Thank you. Loading screens are cool as well, but overall, I just like the atmosphere of this game. When you come into it, you feel like you're involved in this world, and I like that, to be honest. So again, we're going to pick regular. So, and then obviously AI conductor. So this is the cab. Again, as I said, it's good detailed. I think overall in this game the details kind of gone a little down since the previous one, but I don't know, this is based on like an older time where like there's less information for like TML to get to like make very, very detailed trains or whatever, but for generally this is really good. So the cab is good. We have the 7, if you press 789 you get your kind of information where you're supposed to go. So it's Friday time, and then it gives you a route monitor. I like that that information is smaller than in World of Subways Volume 3. I thought in World of Subways Volume 3, I thought it was very big and it was taking too much of the screen, so I like that it minimized it. So, a few things that we need to do before we get going. If I press 5 and then press Control to get the mouse, we have to put the passenger room's light on, we have to put the cab, we don't, I like to keep the cab light off. Headlight on, we're gonna, and also passenger room ventilation. If I now press plus, I get to see in front of the train. I get to change the destination boards, which I can do with page up or page down. So I'm going to go down. I'm going to go put Times Square because we're going to go to Times Square. And you can see it's local. I can switch it to express, but we're not doing the express. We'll switch it when we get to Times Square, which will be in the next video. And yeah, I think that is all we have to do. Headlights are on, which is good. We'll press 1 to get back into the cab. Then here is where you can control the doors. If you have, you have to actually have a door control key, and as you can see there, it says as you're a driver, you do not have the door key, only the conductor has, because the conductor controls the doors. But anyway, we don't need any of that. We're going to get on the way here. What you do to get the brake, if you know, you press the dash to get the reverser, you put the reverser in forward, you press start to put down the brake lever, and then you press the left arrow to get it all the way down. I can take away the mouse now, we don't really need the mouse now. You press the left arrow to get all the way down, release the brake. You press space to lower the dead man's handle. And that should be pretty much it. I think we're ready to go. So we can now press up arrow. And that will get us moving. There's stages of the acceleration, which you can press like the first stage, which goes up to 6 miles an hour. Second stage, which goes up to 16 miles an hour. And then the next stage, I think, goes up to 35. And then the final stage goes up to something like 45. But the speed limits tend to be around either 20, 35, or 15. And sometimes 40 as well. So we're going to go along here. We're going to increase the speed up a little bit as well. But overall, I like the graphics are pretty good. Like, most of this game is outside, so that's obviously something that. And if you press 2, we have finally got back an external camera, which I am so happy because I hated in Volume 3 that there was no external camera. I want to see my damn train, you know? There's no interior view. That's one thing that I. The only way you can get an interior view is if you go into the dynamic camera and hope that it will swoop past in the interior, which you can do by pressing the full stop on the numpad. So right line like that, it will just go into like a dynamic camera where it would just swoop through the carriage and then it will go outside in a few seconds if it does, like that. And that's a dynamic camera. You have no control of that. You can only press enter to kind of reset it to another position. It can even go to the forward position here, but it won't actually stay here for that long. It will just change into something else. Anyway, get back into the cab and just do some driving. Moving on forward here, 60 miles an hour in a 20. Let's just stay that like this for now. I have to say, overall, the game the graphics are good. I personally think World of Subways Volume 3 had better graphics, but genuinely, this is really good. As most of this is outside, and I think probably, you know, making assets and stuff for the outside kind of world is much more harder than making like stuff for underground, which is much easier. You have less stuff to do, and it you can make something that doesn't necessarily have to be so detailed, very detailed, because you're in like a dark area, while in the outside everything kind of gets blown up because of the light and stuff that you have. Anyway, we are now entering 111th Street or Queen Street or whatever it's called. So I'm gonna take off the dead man's handle. I'm gonna apply brake with the... Ooh, I stopped a little too early there. Let me just go a little forward. There we go. And now you can hear the doors have been opened by the AI conductor. To brake as well, it is right arrow. That's one thing that was really confusing. The whole switch from like how you brake and stuff is just confusing, because there's obviously there's a dead man switch and then a brake thing. So now doors are closed. Let's release the brake and add some power. I'll put it in step 3 because we have now a 35 mile an hour speed limit, which is good. Keep it going. The AI is actually fantastic as well. You're gonna be seeing a lot of local passenger service AI, and also some express, which the express is really cool when it goes like flying past you, which is really nice. And there's a lot of elevations and stuff, like you can see here, this like kind of flyovers like next to us, which is for the express service, which doesn't stop at that stop that we just stopped at. Right, coming out now to Corona Plaza, I think it's called. Gonna let go of the power now, add a bit of brake. Sounds are actually pretty decent as well, but some of the sounds have been recycled. That's one thing to kind of take a note there. It has been recycled from the previous game, but it doesn't really bother me too much. It's not too noticeable. But anyway, as you can see, something else, look at this, passengers that actually walk, animated very well. They get onto the train, they sit down on the train, they get off when they need to get off. And it's all dynamically done. Now, I'm sorry, but that is epic. Like, if Train Sim had these kind of passenger animations, yes, please. Like, that would just make Train Sim go to another level. If people can actually walk onto a train, sit down, and then when they need to get off, you know, get off and then get off and go onto the station, why can't Train Sim have that? And as also you can see, the environment's actually pretty good as well. You have some AI traffic and stuff around. Obviously, that isn't done to like a very good amount of detail, but it's a good amount of detail to kind of make it believable around the whole kind of environment that we're driving in. Back in the cab now. Junction Boulevard now, and this is one of the stations that the express service stops on, I do believe. All good. Like, I can definitely see, because I got, like, I've played this game already now for a good few hours, just, like, getting used to the control, but I can see myself starting a shift and trying to finish it all, because it definitely feels like it makes you want to kind of finish your shift. And then also some more things here in the cab. You have the horn, which is cool. Reset switch panel. This is like to just reset things to kind of make them go back to default. Let me just get the train moving and I'll explain some more. Get into stage two. You have a destination board down and up. That's, you can do that from inside the cab, like I showed you with the going to plus. You can do that from inside the cab. Then you have a traveling light, which this, as you can see already, there are headlights on the train, but in tunnels, those headlights actually won't work too well. So you need to put on these traveling lights, which are like much stronger beams, which allow you to like look further distances in the tunnels. But there's also a thing in this game that, like, you know, it rates you on the skill of you how you drive, and having the travel lights on while you're going through a station is a big no-no. You need to have them off when you go through a station, because obviously they're very bright and they're apparently, you know, they can cause accidents and passengers don't like them or whatever, so you have to keep them off while going through a station. But generally I tend to keep them on when I'm going through tunnels. There's no point of having them on right now for like a sunny day. Maybe as well also in the night is a good place to have them on. And then at the very bottom you have a cab ventilation, which you can turn on, and then a fan up there starts turning on. Okay, we're going to have to slow down here. I found that the brakes, people are going to have a little bit of a hard time getting used to the brakes, because the brakes are a bit, you feel like you're going slow, and then you get up to here, and then it's sometimes, like right now, like I felt like I was going a little too fast. But it's weird. You need to get used to this train and how it reacts, because it's still, it's a very, and for me, it's a very new curve, a learning curve here. It's nothing like Volume 3. It's nothing like Volume 2 as well. Volume 2 was more, it was very weird, because you had the two different trains in Volume 2. You had the older train and you had the newer train. The newer train was very easy to drive because you have different speed sets and stuff like that. And the older train was much more harder because you had the kind of cipher and stuff like that, which was crazy as well. Anyway, let's put that into stage 3, actually, because we have 35 miles an hour. I'm going to turn off that ventilation because it's kind of annoying and it's kind of, like, loud as well. Also, you have the driver's window, which you can lower with K and lift up with L, which is really nice. We can leave it open. It's a nice day. And as I was saying down here, this is what you would control the doors with if you didn't have a conductor. And one thing I actually found out is if you start a shift from another station where you take over a train from another driver, you go into the, like, I did one for the express service and I started at Flushing Main, and I got to the station. I got spawned onto the station, and a train came in, and then I went to the cab, and then a driver came out and he was like, oh yeah, just finished the shift, it was not too bad, you can take it on or whatever. And it was really cool, like that's really nice. I like that kind of interactability that you have, like you have drivers that you can take over shifts from and they actually interact with you when you take over their shift, which is cool. Look at that, it's good. There are two types of trains in this, like if you guys have been listening to the, well not listening, but if you've been looking at the World of Subways Facebook fan page and also TML's blog about this game, there are actually two types of trains. They don't look too different from each other, to be honest. There's like one that has like a side that's fully red and with no windows, and one that has windows all the time. But most of the trains are pretty much the same anyway. You have also these cool blinds here that tell you the station. was it? Yeah, tells you the destination station, and then tells you what station it came from, and then tells you if it's a Flushing Local or Flushing Local Express, which is pretty cool. But so far, I would definitely recommend this game. The price tag is a bit... I was surprised with the price tag, actually. It's quite high. Like, I thought it would be... Well, to be honest, it's a good price, I guess. To be honest, for the detail and stuff that has gone into this game, I think it's a justifiable price. It's about... if you guys don't know what the price is, it is about $26.99, I do believe. So it's about the same price as Ompsy. And at least this game works. I know that there have actually been some launch issues with people loading the game and the game coming up in a black screen. I think they've done a hot fix for that already, I think, with an update. Let's go. You can also see here that's the pressure bar that we look at for the brakes to show you when we actually can accelerate. It's all good. Does it accelerating up here? They're not really fast accelerating trains, these old subway trains, but they get up to the speed they need to go. The local service is pretty good. You have a very quick stations, like this is station, like then this next station is literally pretty much just a minute walk away. But I've tried also the express. The express is refreshing if you don't want to do the whole. If you don't want to do the whole thing, but you're gonna have to. If you're gonna do a full shift, you're gonna have to drive a local express to do one stretch, and then it will allow you to do the express, because as I said, the express isn't bi-directional. It's only in one direction. And as I said, I think because when I spawned into the game, I started off in somewhere in. I think in March or somewhere, and the express was going this way forward that I'm going, and then when I spawned somewhere in the summer, it was going the other way. So I think it changes with seasons or holidays or whatever, this express direction changes, which is pretty cool as well, I guess. We could speed up here a little bit. Coming up also to our next station, which is Woodside, which is another station for the express service. But I'll show you all these kind of stations on the express service in like another video. All is good. Let's try and do a stop from the external camera. I wish the external camera can be like moved. Find that it's only at the front carriage that you get to have it. There we go. And you can see, look at the passengers, they're all interacting nicely with each other. It's all good. It's really nice. Got the nice little ding that tells some of the passengers get caught in the doors, but you know, that's real life, I guess. Brake pressure building up, probably. And off we go. Station details are actually alright as well. I don't think I've seen an express train so far yet. Maybe one will pass us eventually. But yeah. And then actually here, if you can open the door and you can like see a passenger's like, hello there. It's like, you're looking at me watching me drive this train. Do not lean on the door. Well, most of the AI lean on the door, but you know, that's cool. Attention to detail there. When we get to... when we get to, like, I think when we get to a, because we're kind of running a little late now, I think we'll get to, like, one of the stations on the outside, and I'll go and walk around and show you that you can actually get up and actually walk around and go through your train and walk on the platforms, which is pretty cool. And then also, so right now there's one, two, three, four, five, six underground stations, which is pretty cool. And then the rest are all above ground. Each of the terminuses are underground, and they're pretty cool. Like in the Flushing mains. It has like three platforms and one like platform in the middle that has like two platforms to either side, which is really cool. And then like you get like it's really cool to just be looking at the AI just like, you know, coming in and then changing shifts as well, and then you being involved in that as well, which is really cool. But so far, I think this game is shaping up to be a really good addition. I'm very happy with it. It was a good wait for it. I hope it does well in sales, because it definitely does deserve to. Alright, quite an empty station here at Bliss Street. Also have like different cameras and stuff for these kind of each sections and stuff like that. Oh, no one wants to get off there. All good. I wish there was more camera views though. Like, I wish the external camera had a bit more views. I wish that we had an interior camera, which would have been really nice. I enjoyed having like an interior camera in the Subways Volume 2. Like, that was just, it was so fun to just stay in the interior and just drive from the interior, really. But overall, this is really good. I like, they've kind of taken out best bits from each game and kind of put them into one in some sense. And I hope that this series continues, and I hope we get like maybe the next city a bit more modern trains, but I like the older trains, they're cool. Anyway, I'm gonna have to, you can see what I'm doing here now with the brakes and stuff. It does take a bit of responsive time for the brakes to kick in, I have to say. Like that. There you go. I'll move the camera up so you guys can see more of the view. Alright. You also have like these kind of cameras, I forgot to mention, that just you pop your head out of the cab for each side, and that you just press shift, left shift or right shift, really. Put stage 3. Oh, is this a... oh no, it's not an express. I haven't seen an express now in so long. I've only been passing local services, really. But I don't know what direction it is the express is going, so I wouldn't be able to tell you. Or maybe it's actually just not... Oh, actually, I'm doing the express. No, so it's coming from the opposite direction, because the next shift of this train that I'm driving will be an express back to main, Flushing mains. As he does it. I'll also try and do some of the videos of the missions and stuff like that. You can see here you have 6 to 8 car stops, and then 10 to... 12, no, 10 to 11. Which means that you have also shorter trains, but I've not seen any of the shorter trains yet. I've only seen the kind of longer trains. But I don't mind. I like the long trains better than the short trains. Alright, get that going. Set to stage 3. That should hopefully get us going and moving. But I'm really impressed with this game, actually. I love the... One of the things I love is the passengers. The passengers interact like passengers on trains. Which is cool. gonna have to lower the throttle now because we're going around the bend. Next station is Queensborough Plaza, I think. Queen Street or something like that, I don't know. I'll also get out and walk a bit on this station and show you that you can walk around, and then we'll do a little walk around at the last station, Time Street. Times Square. But tell me, guys, what you think. What do you think by just, like, watching this video? What do you think if you have the game? Tell me your experiences of it. Are you enjoying it? I definitely am. I like it. It was a bit of a challenge getting used to. As I said, the controls were a little bit, like, you know, new controls, new layout and stuff. It was definitely a bit of an experience trying to get things working. Is this an express? It might be an express. I'm not too sure. It is a local. Okay. Still haven't seen an express. Lovely. Some of the textures are really good, actually, to be honest. Right. And this station's actually where another line intersects it, but I don't think there's any AI for that line. I'm not too sure. Right, nicely does it. I'm going to be very quick here because we're kind of 1 minute late. I don't want to be too late. But I'll... There we go. So, when you get up, the conductor actually doesn't close the doors because he knows that you're not there. So look, we can walk around. We can walk around our train. Detail in here is pretty good. As you can see here, the ceiling here with the ventilation and stuff like that. You have the passengers that have all, like, boarded and sat down. When we have to go to the depot, they all empty out. They don't stay there. One thing that I miss is you can't open these doors. You can't go through there. I have to say, obviously, I think volume-free interior of the C-stock was much better textured. And this is also something to do with, like, because obviously this is an old train. It probably won't be able to get quite a lot of, like, information about it and data and, like, you know, proper, like, textures and pictures and stuff of it. So it's kind of, you know, it's kind of understandable that it isn't done to as really good detail as, like, the previous game, which has a train which is, like, you know, it's still around and in service today. Well, the C-stock isn't right now, but it was when the game was being developed. So you can walk around stations. You can't go down these kind of stairs or upstairs, which is a shame, like you could do in World of Subways Volume 3. Understandable, I guess. But overall, you can walk around stations. You can get onto other AI trains and, you know, go on the AI trains or whatever. I'm pressing shift to run. You can see there's a bit of lens flare as well. But anyway, I want to continue because we are kind of running a little late. So I'm going to go back here, close the door, press C to get back in. See, my the conductor AI just quickly kicks in and knows that I'm back in the seat. Bring up the information. And hopefully we are ready to go. Yes, we are. Excellent. 15 miles an hour here. As you can see, the one of the branch lines branches off in that direction. I don't know if maybe that's probably another line. I don't know what line it is, but it's another line. I haven't seen any trains on that part of the line because, I don't know, probably AI wasn't programmed for that. You can see traffic there building up with the environmental cars and stuff, which is pretty cool. Right, let's add some bit more power going up this incline. Next station is Court Square. Can add a bit more power. Get to 20 and then let it level off. Great. Release the power and just roll into the station for whatever, Court Square. But the weather's really good as well. Like, the first weather I drove in was in snow, which was really good. The snow particle effects are really good. The rain, like, sticks onto the window and whatever. The sun's really nice. This kind of weather's really nice. The reflections and the lighting is really good. You have other stuff like storms and stuff, which is really cool. So you have quite a lot to play around with in terms of, like, customizing how you want to, you know, go out and drive. One thing also, when you're walking around and you drop onto the platform, the same thing doesn't happen like in World of Subways Volume 3, where you just drop through and then land in a train. You actually just walk around the track, which is really cool. And then to get back onto the platform, there are actually stairs at some of the ends of platforms, so you can just walk up like here. That's gonna come up. Hopefully, you can see that there's like a stair, a little staircase that you can just use to get back up to the platform, which is cool. So you can go exploring around on the track if you want to, and then just get back up onto a platform, which is cool. Right, I do believe now we're going to be heading into the underground section of the... Oh, this is an express service. Oh, there we go. There's the express. One of the expresses. We're going to head into the underground section of this part of the line. This is the section that has, like, the few concurring stations. So you're going to have, I think there's, like, four or five that just go in a row. And then the one on the other side of the line is just one station at the very end that's underground. And that's the terminus of Flushing Main. But here we go anyway. We're turning in quite a bit of a sharp turn. And then on a nice decline down into the tunnels. And like over there, I think those are the Twin Towers, aren't they? Because obviously this is based in the 70s, 80s, they would have still been around. So Twin Towers over there and all of Manhattan and its glory. At the end of the war, we terminate at Times Square. So, right, increase a little bit of power. And we enter Hunter's something, PT. What the hell's PT Plaza? No, not Plaza, but Plaza doesn't have a T in it. Hunter's Plate. Interesting name there. Nicely does it. Some of the costumes and stuff that... some of the clothing wear that some of the AI wear. It's quite hilarious. There we go. Nicely does it. Few more stops and then that'll be the destination, and then I think in the next video I'll do the return trip as an express. There we go. Wait for the pressure to build up, and now this is where we can actually put on our traveling lights. So if I get my mouse up with control, once we get into the tunnels, not near the platform, we turn on our traveling lights. And even though they pretty much don't do too much, in all fairness, they just give a little bit more of a shine. But if you had them off, it doesn't really look like you have any lights on. And then in the tunnels, you don't have any exterior camera, so the exterior view is disabled. But you still have a dynamic camera, which you can activate there. And then you can press enter to kind of give different views, which is pretty cool. So that's a back. And yeah. Stuff like that, and it stays there for like 10-15 seconds, which is pretty cool. You can see that the really high strong beam of the traveling lights. Anyway, back into the cab. I'm going to turn off the traveling lights because we don't want to blind our passengers as we enter Vernon Boulevard. As he does it, I'm going a little too slow, but doesn't really matter. We'll just roll in like this now. And start braking after I see the... Oh, there we go. There we go. I see it does it. I'll need to find out how you do the conductor mode. That's something I need to find out how you do it. But that will obviously do like in a future video. Right. And And off we go. I think this is... I don't know how to turn my travelling lights on. I think this is going to be the longest section in tunnel. I think it's something like 6,000 or 7,000... whatever they use, meters or feet, or I don't know. Feet, why would you use feet in natural? Yards, I don't know, something. It's the longest section that you get to drive. Yeah, they use feet, I don't know. But this is the longest thing, so we're going to be driving a little bit, going a little bit fast, which is cool. Get up to 40 miles an hour and rock and roll. Then power up one more time. We can go and have a look at the different cinematic views, which are pretty cool. Going a little fast here, going at 50. Lower down one, but it's a rain man. We need to catch up for today anyway. Oh, this is not the dynamic camera. You can have a front camera like this, which you press the little dash above the plus, or the minus. And this is now the dynamic camera, which will probably change any moment now. Some weird shots, obviously, but can't really do too much in the dynamic camera in the tunnel. Those are the kind of cool shots you can do. I'm gonna get back in the cab. We are zooming in. I don't know what this particle effect is. It's like we're going through a galaxy or something. I'm gonna turn off the lights out now. And we're entering Grand Central Station. Nicely does it. One step of brake. Quite a nice big kind of spacey underground station. Probably the most modern looking one out of all the underground stations, to be honest. Does it? There goes the brake. Let's go and see if we can have a look at the outside there. And off we go. I think the next station is our final stop. Or maybe there's one more stop, I'm not too sure if I remember. Even though, as I said, some of the sounds are... Oh no, we have one more stop by Bryant Park. Even though I've said that some of the sounds are recycled, you can tell that they've kind of used the recycled sound but changed them in a good way and, like, you know, made it a little bit different. Because obviously you hear different sounds on, like, this kind of type of subway than you do on the underground. Right. Bryant Park. And then it is Times Square. Yes, it does it. Nice. Can have a little peek outside what's happening. Nothing really much. On a bit of an incline here. Downcline. Decline, whatever. Right. And to the last station, Times Square. Hopefully we'll see some AI that's already parked up in Times Square. Traveling lights again. They can see some AI there. That's the AI probably coming out. That's Terminator. That's an express service, and I'll probably be an express service as well. So I might have to actually wait here a little bit before I can leave, because there might be a local service that come in after me and then leave after me, probably. Good time traveler. It's on. Off. Good, we're here. Last stop, Times Square. There we go. We have the accelerator and some brake. There we go. All done. And then when they finish, it asks you, would you like to continue the schedule? And I'm going to say yes, because I'm going to record the next one, which will be hopefully be the Express. Yes, it is. Now it tells me the type up there is Express, so I'm going to be driving back the Express. But that's for another video. I'll also show you what I do, like, with setting up and stuff and going back the other way in the next video. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. Tell me your thoughts down below. I'm sorry I didn't do any shouts for this video. I promise I'll do them for the next video. I'm really sorry. I just remembered now that I forgot to do any shoutouts. But yeah, I'll continue to shout outs like the next video. I keep sometimes when I start recording, I get so excited I just completely blur out the shoutouts on my like other screen. But I was excited. What can I say? Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Join me for some more. We'll definitely be recording some more. Tell me your thoughts in the comments section below. I'll see you in another video. See you guys. We ain't never given up 'cause